What if you want to control ProPresenter from anywhere on the same network? Using your iPhone or your iPad or your Android phone. How can you do that? Well, you might know about ProRemote, but a lot has changed. So let's find out more about that. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter version 20? Part 2, the ProPresenter Remote app. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever thought, man, they really need to put some work into the ProPresenter Remote app, and you wondered when macros and other stuff were going to arrive, well, tell me about it below. So, with version 20, as always, there's tons of bug fixes and other stuff that they're doing to make ProPresenter better than ever before. Earlier, we talked about workspaces. So if you missed part one, then by all means, go back and watch that. But if you didn't, the other thing that you should consider is this new feature. And there's a couple of things about it. So let's head over to the computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in ProPresenter, and let me go ahead and connect here. And yeah, of course. Let's see if I can just get this to show up real quick. Yeah, here we are. And first thing, it shows me my connection. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And that should bring that up. Let's see here. Make sure that, by the way, if you go into setting, ProPresenter, then settings, and then network, you want to make sure that ProRemote is enabled. So that's actually probably what it was that ProRemote was not enabled. So let's click on that again, and there we go. So now we have ProRemote here. This is just mirroring my phone right here. So we're going to interact with it. And notice that I have my libraries. I also have my playlists. So that's pretty cool that I have those two as things right off the top. So let's say that I wanted to go into my sermons library and pick one of those. Here's one. So this is one that I did for a conference, and notice that I have total control. Nice and easy, don't need to be at my computer, and notice that the interface is not jumping to that. That's actually, you might think that's a bug. No, that's actually a feature. That's designed that way so that this can control ProPresenter even when ProPresenter isn't in the foreground. So that's important because, as it turns out, with this, it's not in the foreground. iPhone mirroring is. So that's one thing here. I can go back into playlists and I can select the playlist. So this is the one that I'll use when we come to the end of today's tutorial. So I can just click on stuff there. Other things, I can go in here and I can click on different slides. I can select my different timers, start them, edit them, etc. And now I have macros. So I have all of these macros that I can go ahead and add, and if I click right up here, I have multiple collections that I can do. I can show them as a list instead of thumbnails, or go back to the grid here, and notice how big those are and easy to jump around to. So we'll be right back. one thing that I saw someone who was beta testing this along with me say is, oh, I don't need a Stream Deck anymore. And if all you're using is a Stream Deck to switch between your macros, then you're right, you don't. I like the tactile buttons, but you could do that with either your phone or with the iPad app. So that's cool as well. Let's click down here and select more because I want to show you some of the other features. So we can go through an audio playlist. I can play individual audio stuff. I could go to stage and I can switch between my stage layouts on my individual screens. I can type messages on the stage screen. Here in props, I can select multiple props, and just like with macros, if I click here, I can go to different collections of macros. So that's very helpful for that. I can switch between my looks, and I even have settings here. So I can turn on keep device awake. That'll keep it from going to sleep. But that will drain your battery more quickly, so keep that in mind. We have a place to report issues, learn more, etc. So, a lot of new stuff built into the ProPresenter app. I should also say that I can clear the individual layers here. So, I have that control as well. And so, I can even, if I click on this, I can follow along with the presentation, view this as a list, or make these bigger or smaller. So lots in here. I haven't played with everything that it can do, but I think that this is going to be a valuable tool in your arsenal. Something else for you to know is that now, first off, it only works with version 20 and newer. So don't get it and think, oh, I'm going to use it with version 17. No, you're not. It doesn't work at all. So keep that in mind as a caveat. The second thing is, at least this is my understanding, is that it will be included as long as you have an active ProPresenter subscription. So it's not the case that you've got to pay $10 per app or whatever. It's all included, and so that's something cool as well. So Renewed Vision continues to stretch what ProPresenter can do and increase its capabilities, and it's something that I find just more and more exciting. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from trinitydigitalmedia.com and churchtechu.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.